continue with the first chapter, subtopic D, waste generation, its toxicity and its impact on life and land. Under this we are learning the politics of waste dumping. Now there are some cases of illegal waste dumping. Mostly it is hazardous or toxic by the developed countries, in the developing countries, or by the developed countries in the oceans. So about 400 million tons of waste is being produced globally every year, and a lot of it is just thrown on vacant places like the roadside or the borders of the country or international borders or in the international waters. So this causes a lot of threat to the marine life and also to the life on land. So a convention was started by the many countries came together to start this Basel Convention. Basel is a place in Switzerland, and it was just to stop this illegal trafficking of hazardous waste around the world. So Basel Convention came into action on 5th May. It is actually a convention started to stop the transboundary movements of the hazardous waste throughout the world. And 179 countries have signed, including India. It is an international effort to stop the transboundary movement of the hazardous waste, and there are some aims or objectives of this Basel Convention. Now, first one is to protect human health from the ill effects of this hazardous waste, because sometimes it is carcinogenic, it can cause cancer. So if it is taken care of, then there won't be any problem. Second is to prevent the transboundary movement. Of the same hazardous waste, to reduce the generation of waste, then to treat and dispose the waste at the source itself instead of taking it to another place, it is generated, to take care of the waste there itself, then monitor the and prevent illegal trafficking of waste. I'll just give an example. Some barrels of toxic waste which was sealed and brought by ship to another place, and there it was a big land was taken from a developing country, and the land person in charge of the land was paid. He will not even be knowing whether that waste is bad or very toxic. So he has given the land, and these barrels have been just put into the soil in that area. Now many times ships carry the toxic waste to deep into the ocean and just throw it there. If it is nuclear waste, it has to be sealed properly. Otherwise it is harm to us if it leaks. If it is sealed, it's no problem, but if it leaks, it is harm to humans as well as marine life first. Now, it also provides another aim of Basel Convention is to provide assistance and guidance and financial help to the developing countries to take care of this hazardous waste, and to keep a regular check or regulatory system so that there is no transboundary movement like this happening. Next is type of waste. Now, waste can be classified into many types based on the matter states of matter. It is solid, liquid or gaseous waste based on whether it can be decomposed or not. It is biodegradable and non-biodegradable waste, and based on the source of origin where it is produced, either at home, it is domestic, or if it is in the hospitals, it is biomedical. So, or in the industries, it is industrial waste or commercial waste, or sometimes it is just e-waste. That is, all our computers or equipments which like tube light, mics, all these is e-waste. Now, depending on the source, there can be also volcanic waste or thermonuclear waste, depending on the factory or industry where it is made. Now, what is waste actually? Today we are reading a newspaper, tomorrow it becomes waste. So, whatever is of no use any longer, that is actually waste. So, you have to take care of it and don't dump it on any place. So, there are many effects of waste accumulation on land, on life, and on all of us animals. Now, first one is, it becomes a breeding place or feeding place for rodents, for animals, for insects, and at last pathogens, germs. So when there are animals which are infected by germs, it is one way of spreading disease. So there will be disease. The second one is, when untreated biomedical waste is being dumped on the roadside or dustbins without treating, then it has a lot of pathogens. So it is also another cause of infection, or whoever is handling it, like rag pickers, they don't know, they just take things from the dustbins on the road and they take it to a place, so they are most vulnerable. Third is toxic chemical waste. Sometimes it is toxic, that is very bad for health. They can be causing biomagnification. This toxic waste, when it reaches the ground or the water bodies, then the amount increases in the fish, and then when the fish is eaten by us, it increases in us, and this is called biomagnification. If there is biodegradable waste, then what will happen when decomposition takes place or decay takes place? A very bad foul odor will be there. So that is also another problem to us. Then there is encroachment of roads. Now if the road is there, when little waste is thrown, there is no problem. But when waste accumulates on both the sides of the road becomes narrower for vehicles to move. So this is encroachment of roads and even the fields. any place which is just barren land sometimes is used by people just to throw waste. So they are encroaching that area. Then this, it spoils the aesthetic beauty of the place. Aesthetic beauty is the beauty of the place, any landscape. Because of the waste, there will be less tourists coming to that place, or it won't attract any people. So the aesthetic beauty of the place is lost. Now there is another problem with the agricultural waste, that is the pesticides and the fertilizers. Again, this agricultural waste will go, because of the drainage, it will go into the water bodies, and some will remain in the on the land soil, and it causes again biomagnification and eutrophication. Now what is biomagnification? I have already told you, it increases in every food level of the food chain, and it's bad for health because it remains in the tissues of the first animal and it doesn't harm it. But when we eat or a bird eats that earthworm, the amount of toxin in that earthworm, it will increase in the bird and it will harm the bird. Now eutrophication is a similar phenomenon. What happens is the fertilizers, when they go into the water bodies, the animals there, or mostly the algae, with the help of this nutrition, they grow in a vast area. No other animal can get food and no light can penetrate inside the water. So the other animals suffer because of the oxygen is less, because of algae is taking all the oxygen and making a carpet like on the surface of the water. So other animals have to either migrate or some of them will die because there's no oxygen left in the water. And if this continues for a long time, then these algae will die and they will be decomposed by the bacteria, and other animals will not get oxygen at all, and in a long run it becomes a dead lake or a dead pond. Now waste which is gaseous, like carbon monoxide or carbon dioxide, they destroy the vegetation and also they harm the aquatic animals. Because of this acid rain, it goes up, it forms the clouds of acids and come as acid rain. So again it will harm the aquatic life too in the water. Now coming to how the waste is handled. When this waste is being thrown in a place, like you all must have seen this waste in this Sansada. Similarly, it is thrown or disposed in an area like Sansada. It is called a landfill. When this landfill is scientifically designed to take care of the waste, it is called a sanitary landfill. So, actually, a sanitary landfill is a low-lying area or a barren land where the waste is dumped and a lot of soil is put over it so that the waste is not exposed to the outside. So no animals and rodents will be coming in contact with the waste because it is totally covered by a layer of soil. So still there are problems with this. The first problem is leaching. Now what happens is, when it rains or some liquid waste, if by mistake if liquid waste is thrown there, then what happens is, through, because of the drainage, because the soil is porous, all the water or the liquid waste will just move from this place, from the landfill, to the inner parts of the land, to the groundwater, like wells. It will reach your wells, it will also reach the water bodies, and this toxic waste liquid which comes from the landfills is called leachate. If it is something like non-toxic, it won't harm, but if it is toxic waste, like batteries and all are thrown there, it mixes into it, then it is very fatal for us. Now leaching, this is called leaching of this leachate. So it is liquid waste or which either drains into the water bodies or inner land, or sometimes it overflows during floods or during rains. Now, so this is mostly leaching of toxins. It is very bad effects on life. First thing is, we are learning its effect on two things. One is the water bodies, and second is the agricultural land. Now what happens when it goes into the water bodies? It causes biomagnification, because the toxin goes into the water body, it is taken by the fish, then the fish is eaten by humans or other animals, and it goes into their body. So this toxins from the leachate reaches us, so that is biomagnification. Same thing happens here when it goes into the agricultural land. The animals or the ground worms like earthworms and some other mites, they take it in. The bald eagle, this is example, bald eagle might eat the earthworms, and the bald eagles are affected. Their eggs today are becoming brittle. Before hatching they break and the population has gone down. Now second is, this causes a lot of disease when it comes into human body. Because of biomagnification, these toxins, they cause a lot of disease, even disease to the crops. On the agricultural field, it also causes disease to the crops. Then aquatic life is destroyed here, because they cannot live in this toxic environment. Sometimes your metallic bodies like the ships and all which move, they get corroded because of this toxins. Some chemicals are so harmful that they can cause corrosion like rusting etc. for the ships. In case they are metallic, and most of the ships are metallic. Now coming to this, again the water body also loses its transparent nature. Water is actually transparent, so it becomes turbid because of this leachate which comes here. It becomes turbid, you cannot see inside what is in the water, so it becomes turbid. Now coming to this, it kills the soil organisms like earthworm and others. Then it also causes disease if it is harmful to the plants and the animals which live in there. It causes also disease to them. Mostly it remains in the tissue of them like earthworms and other animals, and it harms them. Another thing is, it kills the natural organisms. This can be also butterflies, because they are the ones who visit the plants all the time. Now coming to the next one, these landfills help to stop this leachate flowing into the water bodies and agricultural land, because the landfill takes care of the waste so that it doesn't flow or overflow, the leachate doesn't overflow. Study some advantages and disadvantages of landfills. So first one is, if the land is available, then there won't be any problem because it is economical. Second is, initial investment is low. Third is, no additional methods are required for taking care of the waste. And the fourth one is all kinds of waste can be disposed of here, but it is better to keep out the liquid waste. Now the disadvantages are, if suitable land is available, then it will be fine, but if it is far off, very far place, then there will be lot of money spent or expense on the transporting the waste from a very far place to that area. Then second is, proper methods should be used, otherwise it will be causing again leaching or foul smell, etc. Then the third is, periodic maintenance is required of this landfill. And the fourth one is, when decomposition takes place, there is methane gas which is evolved and which gives a very bad odor. Now coming to the next one is incineration, issues around incineration. This is another method of treating solid waste at source. Now what is incineration? It is treating combustible waste only at a very high temperature. It is burnt in a metallic furnace. So metallic furnace is used, and the temperature is about 670 degrees centigrade. Now solid waste here has to be segregated first into combustible and non-combustible waste, and only combustible waste can be treated here. Mostly it is used for biomedical waste because it has a lot of infection causing organisms, pathogens, so they are incinerated. In the hospitals they have them. So incinerators also have advantages and disadvantages. The first one is, about 20 to 30% of the waste is reduced. Then disposing hazardous waste becomes easy, toxic waste or infectious waste in the hospitals, etc., because it will not spread the disease. The third is, pollution is less. Then also less land is required, because it only one machinery, that is the metallic furnace, has to be kept, and very less time consuming. Now these advantages are, if by mistake some plastic or some metal is put into the furnace, it causes pollution, because it gives out a substance after burning, dioxin. So it is carcinogenic. So it has to be tackled well. Segregation is a must. Your disadvantage, if it is not segregated, it will cause more pollution than usual. Then installation, operation and also the maintenance is very costly. So this is for today. Let us continue in the next video.